Today we are going to get started a new lesson, that is 17th lesson, Understanding Poverty. So here in this lesson we are going to look after about the poverty. What is the, you may need to get understand about the what is meant by poverty, what are the causes of the poverty. Basically, we have wrote already in the board about the poverty, it's what it means. So poverty, it means lack of the basic needs. So what are the basic needs are in of ours? So basically in the previous lesson, during the 9th lesson, we have discussed what are the basic needs. Food, shelter, clothing. With these three aspects, the most important, but still we need to go with the education and the sanitation. These are the five basic concepts of the things which are the basic needs are being required. The very important, the basic needs goes with the food, then goes with the shelter, then goes to the clothing, the basic needs which we have been discussing now. And along with these three, the fourth that we need to go with the sanitation, then next, education rights. Education. So these are the five basic needs that every human need to be get attained. Food, shelter, clothing, sanitation, and the education. So in this regard, in this lesson, we'll be going to have a look on what is the reasons for the poverty, where it existed, how it existed, then what is the need of the government. So all the first of today's class, we'll be going to discuss about the synopsis. At the same time, we'll be going to have the case studies of the persons. So better it will be make you to understand how the things have been getting carried out, like what are the reasons for the poverty, then what government has been doing, or what kind of different schemes, and in the schemes to check out the government, like social audit reports, all the things we will be going to discuss in this lesson. Along with that one, the first one, the about the case studies also in reality, how it is been working out. So before that, this has been not mentioned in your textbook about the types of the poverty, but still to give you aware about what are the different aspects of the poverty, there are six aspects. First is situational poverty, second is generation poverty, third is absolute poverty, fourth is relative poverty, sixth is urban poverty, fifth is urban poverty, and last is rural poverty. Now coming to the situational poverty, means according to the situation, the things are going to get changed, whether it will be increasing or whether it will be decreasing. During like present in the last year or present, we have been suffering from this kind of the COVID aspect, where the salaries have been get reduced and the lockdown, all the this is because on the basis of the situational poverty. Next comes the generalization, because in a particular period of time, for 1 year or 2 years, in a general aspect, the poverty exists out. So absolute poverty is complete acute shortage of the poverty. Relative is according to any aspect, the poverty existing out. So fifth is urban, means in the cities and towns, what kind, how the poverty existing, because in the cities and towns, we will be going to find out the more of education, net rates, more of jobs, but still quite poverty is existing in the urban areas. Last is rural poverty. So rural poverty, basically we can get to know about the villages. So in this, mostly they will be going to depend on the agricultural aspect, and then we might get into the urban areas, and at the same time different government schemes. So all this related towards the rural poverty. So in this class, we will be going to do with the first one, the synopsis of the lesson from the textual page of 193. Synopsis, first subheading is distress in rural areas. Distress in rural areas. What is it? Distress is not completely having the freedom, or not completely going to the work. What other problems arises in the rural areas? The people have been working. If there will be no work, the complete leads to the problem waiting and the child labor, then the hunger, epidemics. All these problems are happening out in the rural areas. So in this rural areas, we are going to have a look on the case study. So distress in the rural areas, in this subtle personal synopsis, we will have the case study. basically the measurement in kilograms and the body, the intake, calories, nutrition, all these things lead to the deficiency in our body. Now next it comes here for inequality. So what is here? Basically we can see here it is about the food inequality. The distribution of the food, how it is been get distributed, what kind of people are been getting, how it is been related. So this is about the food inequality. Here they have been given also the bar graph, the indications, how much the calories have been required for the one person. So this is about the food inequalities because of the more and more people are been get existing in the country, or at the same time the people are poor people, they cannot afford the food, and due to that one imbalance or inequalities in the food being arising up. Now the question, why the poverty? Why poverty is been existing up? How can it be eliminated? How can it be eliminated? So now the question is, why, what is the poverty, why it is required, and how can we eliminate the poverty from our country? Next, we have agriculture source of living. So mostly we can say that India is a country where it relates to the agrarian society, means related to the agricultural aspect. Agriculture source of livelihood.
National
right? All these things. So that is about the social audit report. Next is assist to